and see through lore, so I use the same blade. Uh-huh. One man is a 6-man. But yeah.
Your unlimited boat seats are lower.
A little bit.
Yeah.
You want to be close enough to the water to not have to reach too far to get to it, especially on the right side.
And you sit on the whole seat.
That's something we didn't talk about until we got in the trailer yesterday. Yeah. The first thing I noticed when we worked with the Tahitians 5 years ago, they sit on the whole seat, not the front. Connection to the boat. They want to be connected. Everything is about connection. And I always say, so you're going to go and you're one man and you're going to sit in front of the seat. No. It's going to be totally screwed up.
And I think, too, what you said about going into one man, because I'll hear people that aren't the greatest paddlers say, I'm going to buy a one man, and I'm going to get out there and paddle my one man. I'm not going to paddle a 6-man. But if you're
it's a personal preference,
but if you're not training correctly, if you're not doing your drills, you can go out there and paddle around and not get any better in a one man, just like in a 6-man.
Doesn't make, right, doesn't make you
get in shape.
Get and do your homework. Watch
anybody
your videos.
Anybody can get in shape. Anybody can get stronger. Those things are easy. Getting better technically is what you need.
Right.
What do you need? You need technique, strength, conditioning, a strong mind, good feel. You want to win a race, you've got to have talent as well. But I've taken teams from like Dana Point Women, who were third roughly placed team in California. They were maybe 8 minutes behind the leader in Catalina. And within 1 year, they flipped over, got it back up, and won by 3 minutes.
Wow. 3 minutes.
And the next year, they won by 4 minutes. And the year after that, the team started getting a little better, and still won by 3 minutes.